Okay, so we talked about rate of change and how the rate of change is the change in y. I want to get everyone's attention. The rate of change is the change in y over the change in x, and that's the slope. And we're going to do exactly the same thing that you were doing. What's different is it's more of a what looks like a graph in algebra versus something you might see in statistics with a scatter plot. I've got a line here, and there are two points designated already. So we're going to... We'll do it a couple different ways. First, I want to just read the slope from the graph, just kind of how we did it the very first thing we did today. So another way to think of the slope is rise over run, because the change in the y, that's the vertical part, and then that's the rise, up, down. And then the change in the x is the horizontal part, so that's the run. So you have to rise before you can run, I think.
Yeah.
You have to rise before you can run. Unless you're sleep running. So, on your paper, draw in a triangle. I want you to draw the rise and then draw the run. Because once you see this, it'll help you a lot. Think of a slope as a triangle. So I'm writing rise over run. Now, if we're given a graph, it's awesome. We just have to count the rise and the run.
Over one?
Yes. So up one, two, three, four, over one. So I'm going to write rise over run equals four over one. That rhymes. Which is four. Does anybody speak French?
No. I'm here to catch
someone who I school very well. Anyone know the word for mountain in French?
No, but I know how to say it in Spanish.
Okay. What is it? Okay. Well, it also starts with the letter M. Mm-hmm. So the slope, we use the letter M, which in my understanding comes from the word for mountain. I guess in English, Spanish, and French, they all start with M. So we use the letter M for slope. Okay? So 4 over 1.
Is that where the M comes into play for
I was supposed to be? You just got it. Okay, let's do B. Draw your slope triangle for B.
1, 1.
Yep.
So M.
One over one is one. Okay, which line is steeper?
A.
Yeah.
A, yeah. So what can you tell about the slope?
Longer.
Yeah, the triangle's longer for sure. It's a higher number, right?
Mm-hmm.
So a higher number is a steeper slope. And also, these slopes are both positive. So what does that mean about the line?
That's a positive slope.
Mm-hmm. Positive slope is increasing, exactly. So we read slope from left to right. This is like you're going up the mountain. This is going up the mountain, but it's not as steep.
Right.
So slope is a measure of...
I don't want to climb A.
No, I don't know. Slope is a measure of steepness.
Good. It's like the stairs of Tabor. Oh, good.
If it's going up to the left, it's positive. Or left to right going up. Left to right going down, then it will be a negative slope. Okay, so Wilbur's going to give you a graph, and you're going to calculate the slope from the graph. Also, we could calculate it using a formula, which this might look daunting, but we've actually already been using this formula today. The change in the y over the change in the x. Weren't we subtracting two y values and then subtracting two x values? So this is another way of writing what we've been doing. y2 minus y1, and these are subscripts, just to indicate the two different points. So these are subscripts over, like it's not y squared, it's y sub 2 over x2 minus x1. Okay, so let's try it. These are actually the same exact points that are on the graphs. So we should get the same answer. We can check our answer. So let's try it out. I like to label my points x1, y1, x2, y2. Feel free to do that if it helps. That way I get everything in the right place. So y2 minus y1, so negative 1 minus 3. Negative 1 minus 1, that's y label, over x2, 0. Is this the same? Are these the same points? I don't think they are. No, they're not. Okay, sorry. I thought they were, but they're not the same two points. It's not going to come out 4. I think B is the same. Okay, so negative 1 minus 1. Negative 2 over negative 3. Okay, 2 negatives makes
a
positive, so our slope is 2/3. So this would be a slope triangle of up 2 over 3. So it's not that it doesn't match. I think this one matches 1, 1, and 0, 0. So let's practice it again. So m equals label x1, y1, x2, y2.
So 0 minus 1?
Mm-hmm. Over 0 minus 1.
Negative 1
over negative 1, which is
1.
Now that is what we got. Those points match that graph. So we've got a slope of 1. So you can find a slope given two points, or given a graph, or given some data. You can find a rate of change. All right, so try the next page. We've just got more practice from here on out. Mm-hmm.